transitioning from information management into workface planning, it is now time to prepare for the creation of installation work packages and the execution of work. The first and most critical component is a workface planning coordinator, typically a member of the construction management team appointed by the AWP champion. One of the workface planning coordinator's first activities will be to work with the information manager and the software vendor to populate the WFP software with all the elements that are being created in detailed design and fabrication. This brings the 3D WFP software to life, at which point we start to see the full potential of project information visually represented in a 3D environment. Moving into construction, the workface planning coordinator, working with the construction contractor, develops a department of workface planners and trains them on how to use the software to create installation work packages. The coordinator manages the department to ensure that constraints are identified and removed, and that the department maintains a backlog of executable work. Training sessions conducted for field supervisors and construction management will define their changing roles and responsibilities in support of workface planning. As each CWP enters the 90-day window, the superintendent and workface planner refine the scope and create an outline for the development of installation work packages based upon the superintendent's execution strategy. The workface planner develops the packages and then works with the accountable parties to remove any constraints. The creation of IWPs for each CWP populates the rolling wave 90-day Level 5 schedule as individual week-long activities. As the materials are confirmed through soft allocation, the IWPs move into backlog, which is then used to develop the 3-week look ahead. The sequence of activities in the schedule are then linked to the IWPs in the 3D model and played out as a 4D simulation of construction. As IWPs enter the 3-week look ahead, the on-site material team bag and tag components so that they are staged and ready to ship, and the scaffold team erect scaffolds to provide access. Immediately prior to being issued to the field, the IWPs are rechecked to ensure latest revision documents, prerequisite work is complete, and that construction equipment is available. Then finally, after all this preparation, we reach the objective. The IWP is issued to the foreman a couple of days before it is due to start, so that they can prepare to execute the work. Along with the tracking of delays and earned value management, we also conduct tool time surveys as a means to monitor productivity. These field surveys capture statistical activity levels on the craft workforce that allow us to plot monthly trends and compare results against industry averages. The tool time studies also record specific events and field level processes that highlight productivity issues outside workface planning. The management of these opportunities leads to continuous incremental improvements. Looking at the big picture, it probably looks big and complex, but hopefully now you have a better understanding of how all the instruments contribute to the orchestra. Before we wrap up, let's have a look at one more way to dissect the infograph that may help you segment the phases.